So today I got a consultation with Anthony and Bob, who are longtime members of Lake Valhalla, which is basically a summer retreat and you could go swimming in a lake, but in the wintertime they go ice fishing.
So Lake Valhalla is about to kick off the ice fishing season very soon. We're hoping that we can get a cake and celebrate the launch.
Ice fishing cake, I gotta think about it. I'm not sure what I wanna do, but I've never actually been ice fishing, and this might be a cool way to satisfy my crave to fish in the winter. I'm gonna make you guys an awesome cake.
All right
man, let's go inside. It's freezing out here. One idea was to be able to have like the ice on top and then like a big oversized cartoony fish. Like a little guy has got like a big fish on the line, you know?
Yeah.
I started to think like, all right, well what if there's like a block of ice and then the cartoon fish and a guy catching it? What if like you're doing a side profile so you could see below the ice? So this was the ice part and then the fish were kind of like swimming back in like under the water. And what if we try to take like a fish tank and put some bass in there?
Well, you know what, too? You could probably use real fish if you had to. Let's let them swim around.
Because nothing goes together like cake and fish.
Yeah.
Oh, maybe we'll put bass in there. Bass will swim in anything.
Where are you going to get bass?
I'll catch them.
And what happens if you don't catch them? Then what?
If there's one thing I know, Valastro men catch fish. Bass, trout, you name it, we catch it. That's what we do.
I will catch the fish. You just want to bet?
You two, me versus you two.
What are we gonna do?
It's gotta be a keeper, or it's gotta be like, you know, 10 inches long.
If I catch a 10-inch bass, loser, he's gotta sit in the kiddie pool while we dump ice and water. You gotta stay in there for a minute.
Oh no,
I'll go for a minute.
Yeah,
oh!
You can go to fish, you can go to fish market and get one.
I got it.
I'll go watch some fish.
So the bet is, if I catch a bass over 10 inches long, then Frankie and Danny are gonna have to go in a baby pool and take an ice bath. If I lose and I don't, then I have to take an ice bath for a minute. And I don't like the cold. Not at all.
Oh, there you are, Cake. Look at you hiding in the freezer.
So we had the ice fishing cake in the freezer long enough, so I think it's gonna be frozen enough for us to flip it.
Yeah, we're gonna flip it. Yeah, we're gonna line up.
Line up the back, right?
Yeah. And if this doesn't work, we basically gotta start the whole kick over. Ready?
Yeah, you think?
Which way?
Up, flip.
No.
Keep flipping.
Flipped like it was a cold cup pie. What's wrong with you?
We were both in each other's
way. It's the biggest cake I've ever flipped.
We froze it, we flipped it, bada bing, bada boom. There's nothing I can't handle, baby. Fish and a fisherman look amazing. And I mean, by adding the tank with the real fish in there, this is gonna be one of the coolest cakes we ever did.
It's a lake.
Ready, Ralph?
How about a little help? Yeah.
I can only offer a little.
Watch your fingers. Watch your fingers.
Watch your fingers.
Guide me.
You down.
Be good.
Oh, he ain't going anywhere.
That's beautiful.
So for the bottom of the cake, we figured out a really cool technique.
Are those rocks candy?
Wow.
We're using cake crumbs and candy rocks to make it look like the lake bottom.
Good, perfect. Wait, one more.
The top, we want it to look like a block of ice. And I'm thinking isomalt is the closest thing that you're gonna get to look like an ice cube. Isomalt is basically sugar. We heat it up and we melt it. And as it cools down, it turns into what we call pulled sugar. And then you can manipulate it and turn it into whatever you like.
I even would think if there was a way to roll it out into sheets and we could break them like little pieces like this.
We're taking some of the warm isomalt and running it through the sheeter so that when it dries, it'll be nice and brittle. Then we can break it into sections so it looks like a jaggedy piece of ice. And of course, what's a winter wonderland without a few icicles?
They look good. Ruff, do you want to put the little guy on?
Yeah, I could do that.
It's a big, angry fish.
A last thing I do is airbrush this cake with a pearl sheen, just to give it a little icy feel. And this cake is ready for the lake, baby. Wow. It really looks like that's underneath the water, and that's kind of the scene, and it's a chunk of ice. I love it. Good job, guys. Cake looks beautiful. I mean, really happy with the ice and malt, the fish on top. The only thing missing is some fish. You guys ready to catch some fish or what?
Yeah.
Hey, what's up, man? How we doing? Bud,
how's it going?
Pretty good.
Good to see you guys.
So my sons and I get out on the ice, and Bob and Anthony's there with a couple other guys, and I gotta tell you, it's cold.
Mm-hmm. Safe? It's safe.
Wow, this is crazy.
Okay, would you like to try?
Sure.
Drop it in, son.
Let it go there.
So the key is you got a jig. Gotta get a lot of movement on it. Bounce it up and down. Any bites?
So we're there, and we didn't get nothing, not even a nibble.
Where are all the fish? I'm not really too much patient.
And if I don't catch a fish, we're in trouble. Because I bet Frankie and Danny that I would catch a 10-inch bass. And if not, then they're gonna put me in a baby pool full of ice and water for a minute.
Ooh.
Frankie and Danny are going in an ice bath. I'm not. So, hello, bass, you better jump on my line. So about 45 minutes go by. Nobody's getting nothing. Then all of a sudden,
I don't know, I think there might be something on here.
We look.
Oh! Oh! Hey!
That's a big one.
Oh, yeah.
That's 10.
You got 10.
That's 10.
You got 10.
Right,
Frankie's going swimming. Oh, yeah. Daddy's got a fish. I got 10 inches, and Danny and Frankie, you're taking a nice bath. How does it feel?
Oh, yeah.